No, said Penn. My process is progress to propel my popularity to the pinnacle of proud potential, plus puncture and plunder all piles of plain paper for my pleasure. I see, said Pencil. May I make a proposal? Penn said, proceed. Peep this, said Pencil. Perhaps the path you paved is pretentious. Your presumption is that you prevail in the presence of the public, but in private, you ponder your poor perception of prosperity and discover that pride is your prison. Pump, please, said Penn. I'm prone to produce peak performance, predestined for the prize. I'm proactive, prolific, and profound, and I'm bound for prominence, partner. Not to mention my past, I was the property of pimps, players, and crooked politicians. Modern day pirates with pickpockets at local parties. I've signed fake passports, written profanity in playgrounds, and helped pupils pass term papers through plagiarism. I had a rough past. It was pathetic, but I learned to push my way to paradise. But there's a penalty in pushing, said Pencil. What penalty? Said Penn. When that push pummels your peers to the pavement, so, said Penn, I must provide for my pleasure. My prospect takes precedence when it comes to the pursuit of my pedestal. I see, said Pencil. But when your bold point is through, what then will you pursue? Penn was silent. Because this was a potential problem that he had previously predicted, but he was paralyzed by a lack of solution to prevent it. So Pencil continued. He said, what does it profit? Now, Penn, just think, to gain the whole paper but forfeit your ink. See, perseverance has its place when its partner is prudence. It might seem a peculiar package, but it's potent when practiced properly. Maybe you're a bit perplexed by this puzzle, but it's positively pure and practical, and I've got proof. I once was a pen. But you're a pencil, said Penn. I know, but I used to be a pen. My past was pretty pitiful. Anything but proper. I was a procrastinating, prejudiced, premature, perverted punk with no principles or a prelude to the pits. But then I met this prince who told me of a promise and how he paid the price for my past. He was punished for my penalties, then pulled up to paradise where he prepares a place for me at this present time. You see, he changed me from a pen whose ink was permanent into a pencil whose mistakes could be erased. See, Penn, you don't have to play the part of a pushy pen. You can be a pencil and partake in the precious privileges of his peace. But how, said Penn? By simply accepting his gift. Precious gift to make you a pencil. That's it, precisely. You know, pencil is just pen with C-I-L at the end. That's true, said Penn, but what's C-I-L? Christ is leading. That's the difference between your past and your future. Christ is leading. This powerful proclamation penetrated the heart of Penn, and pooped by his previous pain, Penn permitted Pencil to point him towards the proper path. So they prayed and began to praise, and these two pals played on pieces of purple paper with passion. Then Penn produced a puffy pink eraser at his base. Look, Pencil, an eraser is now in its place, but what should I call it? And Pencil said, grace. Then something peculiar popped out of his head. Penn said, whoa. Then Pencil said, as a pen, you were the leader. As a pen, you were the head. But now that you're a pencil, it's time to be led. And that's Pencil and Penn. And so as we look at the gospel for today, we see John baptizing Jesus in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the waters, we heard read so well, the heavens were torn apart and the Spirit descended upon Jesus like a dove. And a voice from heaven says, this is my son. You are my son, the beloved, and with you I am well pleased. Can you feel that powerful moment? In this powerful moment, we see all three expressions of God. We see God the Father co-signing the witness of John by endorsing Jesus as his beloved son. We see God the Son, Jesus being baptized by John as he leads for us by example the way of redemption. And we have God the Holy Spirit
descending like a dove, and we are reminded that the sacrament of baptism is one that is spirit-filled.